In this video, I will show you how to install Central Services Instance for SAP Systems. Okay, just click on Start button, go to Computer, and double click on C drive, and double click on Dump, and double click on Installation Master, and double click on this, and double click on this, and double click on SAP Inst. Okay, here we are going to install SAP Network 7.0 including Enhancement Package 1, Support Release 1. Just expand this triangle. And then SAP Application Server ABAP we are going to install, expand it. And then we are going to install it on Oracle Database, that's why you select Oracle. And actually we should install Central System, that means everything will be, all the components will be installed in the single system. And in this experiment I am going to show you step by step, so that I will select distributed system, and it will we can install step by step, that is global host preparation, that is Central Services Instance will be installed in this, and then database instance, and then central instance. Okay, and in this video I'll show you first how to prepare your system, that is global host preparation. It is called Central Services Instance, and this is the main point of communication between the database instance, central instance. These two instances will use this particular system for communication. In real-time environment, if you are installing SAP systems in distributed environment, you will install all these three components in different servers, that is three servers. Okay, I am going to show you the experiment in single server. In this server only. First I have selected global host preparation, click on next here. It is also called Central Services Instance. NQ and message server will be installed with this step. Okay, and typical I am selecting, just click next here and click OK here to log off. Once it logs off and logs in again, it will be started the installation again. Okay, there is no need to double click on SAP Inst again, just click OK, it will be logged off. Once it is logged off, again you just log in. So you go to VM and select the Control Alt Delete and enter the password, basis 23, and the installation should start automatically. If it doesn't start, you can also start from the directory which is created inside C drive, program files, double click SAP inst underscore instdir, this is NW01 ISABAP or distributed prepare, this is the SAP inst file, you have to double click on it. Normally it should start automatically when you log on. Okay, if it doesn't start, you have to come here and double click on SAP Inst, and it will not ask you to log off again. Directly it will proceed with the installation. Okay, here we have to provide the SAP SID, that is system identifier for the SAP systems. I am just assigning same SID which we have selected for Oracle instance, that is dev, D-E-V. Okay, SAP system ID denoted as SAP SID, database system ID is denoted as DB SID. Okay, right now it is asking only SAP SID, and I given DEV, and remember that the first letter should be, first character should be, it should be a letter, and the second one and third one may be number and letter. Click next. And it is asking for me to provide the master password for the both the users, that is NW7EHP1, this is the host name, and dev, DEVADM, dev is the SID of the system, ADM, and then SAP service dev, that is SID of the system again here. So for everything I am providing the same password,
Repeat the password. The same password. Okay, click next.
Okay, this is parameter summary screen. From here you can check all the parameters which we have selected while installation phase, that is all the before previous screens, that is SAP system ID we have selected is dev, and the DNS domain name for SAP system is itl.net, that is DNS primary suffix we have selected while setting computer fully qualified domain name, and it is local installation, it is not domain installation. And SAP system OS user passwords, we have given the master password, and just click on the next to finish this installation. With this step, your SAP system global system preparation will be done. It is also called central services instance, that means message server and NQ server, NQ service will be installed with this step. Will take some time to finish. So during this time what it will do is it will prepare the system, and it will create under C drive USR folder will be created here. USR folder will be created, let us see. And it is creating the users for SAP system, that is from here right click computer and click on the manage. Taking time, just wait, the wizard, that window, the computer management screen will be open. From there you can see the users information. So creating account NW7EHP1 dev ADM for system dev. So from here if you click on plus button here, if you expand configuration, you should be able to see the users information. Local users and groups. Click users. So dev ADM and SAP service dev, these two users will be created, and the groups also will be created. SAP underscore dev global admin, SAP underscore dev local admin, SAP underscore local admin. Three groups will be created, these three groups. And if you click on users and right click on dev ADM, click properties, it will give you the display of members, member of, that means that particular user belongs to these groups, and also member of these groups, SAP dev global admin and SAP dev local admin, SAP local admin and users. Okay, these things will be created by the installer itself. Okay, just minimize the screen and it is closed. See, it is installing common system files. By this time the USR folder should be created. Yes, it is created, USR folder is created, and it is asking to show me the path of kernel directory. Just click on the browse button here and go to dump. The kernel folder is located under this kernel directory, and you have to select this. So this is the kernel, click OK. The kernel folder is selected here. So complete path is available here. Just click on the next button. It is throwing error. Just select one more is there here. Dump kernel 5. Click OK. Yes, it's taking. Click on OK button here to finish the installation. Just close here. Okay, and close everything from here, and the system is prepared with the global system preparation, that is central services instance is installed. And if you expand SAP systems, nothing is there here. Okay, now you have to run the database instance. This is the central services instance. It is the main communication point between database instance and central instance. Okay, once this is prepared, we can start the database instance. Okay, I hope you got the information about central services instance. It's very simple. I will explain you how to install database instance in next video. Thanks for watching.